If your timeline frames per second is grayed out like this, don't worry, we're gonna fix it real fast. Let's jump into Resolve and get this fixed for you. So here you can see I have a timeline. It's a massive edit that I've done. And as you can see, if I go over here into my project settings, I've got my timeline frame rate set at 24 frames per second. Now that is the correct time base for this project, but let's say I needed to publish it in 30 frames per second for a different region, like say for America, for broadcast, then I would need to reconform this whole timeline into 30p. Now there are a couple of ways that you can do this, but the only way that you can do it without having to change all of your edits is to very simply go up into your media pool. I normally have a folder constructed called timelines. So I'm going to go into my timelines. I'm going to just go down and right click and create a new timeline. When this comes up, I'm going to name it and I'm just going to call it 30 frames per second reconform. And I'm going to uncheck use project settings. This is the most important thing to do, is uncheck use project settings. Once we uncheck use project settings, we can now go into format. We can now change our timeline frame rate to whatever we want. So I know for this, I want to change it to 30p and I'm just going to hit create. And as you can see, it's created a 30 frames per second reconformed timeline for me. Now all I need to do is go and grab all that media that was in the other timeline, copy and paste it into this one. So we're going to go back up to the top of our workspace here. We're going to drop the drop down arrow and we're going to go back to the what my project was called Final Edit. And I'm just going to hit the home key and then we're going to select Option or Alt, depending on whether you're a Windows or Mac. And then we're going to press Y. And the Y key then selects everything ahead of the playhead. So that's basically everything in the timeline if you hit the home key first. You can see there, I've got all of the media selected. So all I'm going to do now is do Command or Control C. I'm going to go back to my 30 frames per second reconform and I'm going to paste that entire edit. And there you have it. You have your reconform project now in 30 frames per second, all ready to go. And it's as easy as that. And we can scrub through our timeline and it's all there ready for export. Now, if we jump down to our export tab and we go down to our frame rate, you can now see that our frame rate is set at 30 frames per second. So it's now correct for what we're looking for the export. And all we need to do is add the job to the render queue, obviously give it a name and then hit render. Okay, hopefully that was helpful and see you in the next one.
Swipe up. Tag your friends, like and subscribe, comment below. If I make this follow, don't let this flop, wait till the